Hi, welcome to our first lecture. In this lecture, we will make an introduction to tree-based methods, and we will see some key concepts such as impurity functions and regularizations. After those, we will have some hands-on sections where we will use sklearn library. Let's start with the class introduction. In this class, we will mostly focus on these two types of important machine learning concepts, tree-based methods and unsampling techniques. Tree-based methods are some simple machine learning algorithms that make some type of predictions, such as classifications or regressions. Unsampling techniques are some techniques that can combine several machine learning models into a single one to make the same type of predictions. Let's also talk about some motivation to use these tree-based methods. Especially in the era of deep learning, you may be wondering, why do we need to use tree-based methods? Deep learning models are usually setting records when it comes to images, videos, audios, and text, but in the real business world, we may not have these type of data sets. What we might have is just a big spreadsheet of data. And if that's the case, we see that tree-based methods are the ones that are setting the records. In fact, the unsampled tree-based methods are often faster, easier to control over fitting, and easier to understand. In general, if we have a tabular dataset, boosting trees are the most successful ones. In 2016, Kaggle analyzed their competitions to see what techniques were used for the winners. And here's this plot. In this plot, we see the years, and we see these methods that the winners used, and we see these percentages here. When we look at this closely, we realize that the deep learning and the gradient-boosted machines are tied for the most winners, and the random forests are close to those. If you combine gradient-boosted machines and the random forest, we see that they actually win more competitions than neural networks. So this shows the power of tree-based methods. Let's talk about our textbook in this class. We will use this PhD thesis by Gil Sloop in this class, and it is titled Understanding Random Forest. It is a very detailed PhD thesis, and it is a good resource for this class.